As-salamu alaykum, Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, our time during the 24 hours has a lot of waste and negativity.
Yes.
Can you give us a tip to make our 24 hours towards positivity?
Yeah, break it into 8 hours. That you try to do your 8 hours of your worshipness, your 8 hours of work, 8 hours of sleep. Balance your life, discipline your life, and like everything else, whatever people do for work and business, or if they've even been trained at the office, do for your spiritual life. That write out on a time organizer what you're going to do. You know, what type of ibadah you're going to do, what type of worshipness you're going to do, what, how many hours you're going to sleep, what all of this, at this time I'm going to sleep, at this time I'm going to do my worshipness, at this time I have this. And in ibadah and worshipness, time with family and loved ones is considered a worshipness. Doing your prayers, doing your zikr, spending time with loved ones and families, teaching your children, doing their homework, is all worshipness for Allah. So it means that if you live a life that regulated and a discipline to it, everything should be good. And if you're listening to these broadcasts, then we have the zikrs, the meditation and all these spiritual practices. So it's all there. Get timeless reality, and that's 2 years of questions and answers in meditation and everything about how to spiritually unlock the heart and unlock these energies, inshaAllah.
This question is from TikTok. As-salamu alaykum, Shaykh.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Shaykh, why can't we forget the wrong things that people did to us and how to overcome it?
Yeah, we have talks on that. We have a whole library of these realities on our page. The moderators can type in nurmuhammad.com and our YouTube channel, depending upon you want the articles or you want the YouTube. If you go to the article, it also has the YouTube inside the article. So you go to nurmuhammad.com and you type in. And these are the two strings that the devil has to have upon people, the past and the future. So there's a rope around your neck which is tied to the past, and there's a rope around your neck that deals with the future. And the devil pulls on these two ropes so that you can never elevate, you can never awaken, you can never arise. And exactly that word of arise means that…
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream, every bit counts. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Ethereal and an ascension into the heavenly realm can't come when you're tied. So people are servants of their past. He said, she did, they did, all the events of the past. So then you train yourself with these teachings that the past is the past, there's nothing you can do about it. What's the learning from it? And you keep training yourself, the past is over, that I forgive for the sake of myself, not that person, because I don't want them to occupy space within my heart and my head, continuously thinking about them, right? You're giving them free rent in your head and in your heart. Why? If you didn't like them, why give them the free rent in your head? So negate them, throw it out, I forgive them, I want nothing to do with that. But as a result, an event had taken place, a harm has taken place, whatever the issue is that when you come to peace with it, you'll find the wisdom in that Allah will use your skill set. Because once you learn to submit and submit and submit, Allah will use your skill set in dealing with people, right? Because if in the ultimate you become in a state of righteousness, you forgive the past, you clarify all your bad characters, you work on the future, what happens? You have a piety within yourself, you'll be able to use those experiences dealing with people. How can you talk to people whom have never been harmed, or a people whom have been harmed and you have never been harmed? You can't, you have nothing to relate with those people. True. Means that in every interaction with people, how can you deal with them if you haven't had a similar issue? And that's why they have very colorful pasts, religious people, pious people, path of spiritual people, not the ones whom study for external knowledge, internal ones whom Allah dragged them all over this dunya. And they're pretty sort of experienced and in many different facets of real life. And Allah then saves them, brings them out. And they can remember all their experiences because you never forget it. You can forgive but you don't forget anything. But you use that in dealing with people, that I understand where this person's coming from, I understand the logic of what this person's feeling or thinking. So God works in mysterious ways, so He has a reason for everyone and all experiences, and we just have to be strong and work through them. When you cut the past, you begin now to fly a little bit higher. And then the future, always worried, 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 what are you going to do, what are you going to do, how are you going to achieve it? And then that becomes your spiritual practices, your meditation, all the light and energy, so that you can begin to see with your heart and soul. The reason you're anxious and worried is because you're in a darkness. Imagine being in a room, they cut off all the lights and there's lots of furniture. Well, you would be very anxious because you don't know, I'm going to hit my head here, I'm going to flip over this couch, I don't know what's in this room. So nervous and anxious people that are always worried about the future, it's like they're in a dark room. So meditate. As soon as you meditate, connect your heart, what happens? Your heart becomes illuminated, and even just the light of a candle comes into your heart to tell you that it's going to be okay. You can see certain obstacles. You feel the nearness and the warmth of the Divine, the Presence, and everything's going to be okay. And then Allah begins to warn you and teach you that, I fed you this many years, don't worry, I'm going to continue to feed you. It's only the devil that puts fear into your heart. So you cut the back, you cut the front string, and before you know it you're able to ascend. And that's with the barakah and the following of guidance and guides, because they're facilitators of these realities. But without guidance, how anyone's going to do anything? Allah didn't create us to be alone and guide ourselves alone and have nothing to do with anything. For Allah gave the example through Prophet and to be the companionship and a community. And as a result, we're a creation that we're in need of each other, and the companionship is then the strongest power against shayateen. And keeping the companionship of the shaykh, the teachings, the guidance, the YouTube, the live broadcast, all of that is based on that companionship. When they're broadcasting now onto these platforms, yes, to stop people from those other channels that they're looking at, and to remember your Lord, even for just a minute, 2 minutes, 30 seconds, we got your attention. You can shift by but you can't leave it from your heart. It'll come around again. And then in the next few clicks, hey, he's still there, that guy. Yeah, he's not going anywhere, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum, Shaykh.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Alhamdulillah, these teachings are really amazing. In respect to the reality of form, light and sound, I want to know how the nur of Muhammad was created. Was it based on sound, kun fayakun, that first brought the light of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ? Please forgive if it's not appropriate to ask.
Yeah, no, we have in the Lore of Light, Haji Amina's book, that is I think the fourth volume of Lore of Light, it talks about the light of Prophet ﷺ, and that Allah was a hidden treasure wanting to be known. And Allah brought that light into an existence, and that Allah's power is ghul. Kun fayakun is for the power of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. that Allah merely brings His qudra and the light and a dot appeared. And all creation within that dot, and that dot called Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the nuqt. What Shaykh Bahu said? Haji Shahid? What Shaykh Bahu said? Give us now.
Ik nukte vich gal mukdi hai, ik nukte vich gal mukdi hai, ik nukte vich gal mukdi hai, phad nukta chhod hisabanu, kar dur kufar deya babanu, phad nukta chhod hisabanu, kar dur kufar deya babanu, la doza دوزخ گور عذابانو لا دوزخ گور عذابانو کر صاف دلے دے خوابانو کر صاف دلے دے خوابانو گل ایسے گھر وچ ڈک دیئے اک نکتے وچ گل مک دیئے اک نکتے وچ گل مک دیئے اک نکتے وچ گل مک دیئے ایویں متھا زمین ਸਾਈਦਾ ਲੰਮਾ ਪਾ ਮਹਿਰਾਬ ਦਿਖਾਈਦਾ ਐਵੇਂ ਮੱਥਾ ਜ਼ਮੀਨ ਗਸਾਈਦਾ ਲੰਮਾ ਪਾ ਮਹਿਰਾਬ ਦਿਖਾਈਦਾ ਪੜ ਕਲਮਾ ਲੋਕ ਹਸਾਈਦਾ ਦਿਲ ਅੰਦਰ ਸਮਝ ਨ ਲਾਈਦਾ ਕਦੀ ਬਾਤ ਸੱਚੀ ਵੀ ਲੁਕਦੀ ਏ ਇੱਕ ਨੁਕਤੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਗੱਲ ਮੁਕਦੀ ਏ ਇੱਕ ਨੁਕਤੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਗੱਲ ਮੁਕਦੀ ਇੱਕ ਨੁਕਤੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਗੱਲ ਮੁਕਦੀ
ਮਾਸ਼ਾਅੱਲਾ ਹਾਉ ਦੀ ਔਲੀ ਅੱਲਾ ਦੇ ਸਿੰਗ ਰਿਸਾਈਟ ਦਿਸ ਬਿਊਟੀਫਿਕ ਵੇ ਆਫ ਟੀਚਿੰਗ ਸੋ ਦੈਟ ਯੋਰ ਹਾਰਟ ਬਰਨਸ ਇਨਟੂ ਇਟ ਦੈਟ ਟੀਚਿੰਗ ਐਂਡ ਪੀਪਲ ਵੁੱਡ ਰਿਸਾਈਟ ਦਿਸ ਬਿਊਟੀਫੁਲ ਨਾਤ ਐਂਡ ਦੇ ਵਰ ਬੀਇੰਗ ਟੋਟ ਡੀਪ ਰਿਐਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਚੇਂਜ ਦੇਅਰ ਇੰਟਾਇਰ ਬੀਇੰਗ ਇਟ ਚੇਂਜਸ ਦ ਇੰਟਾਇਰ ਬੀਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਨੋ ਅ ਰਿਐਲਿਟੀ So this is a Muhammadan reality in which Allah just within nuqt, this entire creation of Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of all creation is in la, is not in la ilaha illallah, but is in Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because la ilaha illallah means don't look here, there's no sharik with Allah. And the kalima, it has to be for everything. It is the expression of oneness. So it means that if we want to understand the oneness, we say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah is a hidden treasure, will always remain a hidden treasure. Nobody will know the immense reality of La ilaha illallah other than what Allah wants Prophet to know. So when wanting to be known brought a nuqt into power, and that's from his Divinely Qul, because it uses the power of the Qur'an, Qaf wal Qur'an al-Majeed. So that Qaf and to the Lam made it to appear, and as a result that nuqt comes. So now if you take a pen and put it on a piece of paper and put it under the microscope. Take a pen, put a dot and then put that dot under the microscope and then zoom in, and the secret of circles opens. Because that nuqt, as soon as you put it into a microscope, what happens? Expands. The dot stays and all of a sudden there's a circumference, is expanding. The point will always remain one. The circumference just keeps expanding. So you turn it on stronger, stronger, it just keeps going out and expanding, but the dot always stays where it is. Means this is the ocean of oneness, in which Allah in that ocean of oneness, like the Divine, the Kingdom, even there Allah is not to be found. But Allah is the power of that center, and as the creation infinitely expands as a circle, and that's why they're always showing creation and galaxies, everything's a circle. Because the circle is in need of a nucleus in the center, and the point from the center to the circumference is equal at all points. That's amana rasul, that my messengers came out with all the same message. No messenger came and said, no, this is a different Allah, then this is a different one, this is a different one. Amana rasul is the secret from the nucleus, that all of them are brothers and they're all radiuses. They reach to every point and every creation to call people back to the nucleus, come back to oneness. Even your idol worshipper, there's no multiple, you're just facing the wrong way. Qul hu, Allahu ahad. It's a command that from this ocean of power that tell all this creation, Allahu ahad, one, turn yourself back around. There is no multiple, it's just they're facing the wrong way, the darkness, and as a result they're being fooled by shaitan, right? They're not in a different orbit, there's no other orbit. It's just this one nuqt, one dot, one atom. And as soon as they turn back, what happens? You can connect back to the nucleus. So what Allah gave you, belly button. Why? That was your reminder, you're connected to something. You're not just free floating, you just came from nowhere. Your belly button and your cord was a reminder. So when they meditate, they can meditate on this point of the stomach and they feel they're still connected, because there's never a time you're not connected to the Divine Presence. So these are where all Allah gave to us, all these points on our body and all these examples. Just put this thing right on your stomach. Oh, you think you were ever something not connected to us, you are connected and you remain connected. But if you're facing the wrong direction, that's your problem. You turn back around and face the warmth and face the power of the Divine, the Presence and the oneness. Qul hu Allahu ahad, Allahu samad. That I am the one whom is sustaining you. Why are you looking there and saying, they're going to do it? I sustain you. So alhamdulillah, inshaAllah Azza wa Jalla, dress and bless us. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifoon, salaamun al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Keep that thought if you have more questions. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar Rahman Ar Rahim. Am I reciting something? No. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin, Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in, Ihdinas Siratal Mustaqim, Siratal Ladina An'amta Alayhim, Ghayril Maghdubi Alayhim Waladdallin. Ameen.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. Inshallah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.